Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see what is deadlock, how can a deadlock be prevented as well as avoided. Okay, so first let's see what is deadlock. Okay, deadlock means it actually in operating system there will be multi-programming means like you know a particular multi-programming environment will have n number of processes as well as n number of resources. Okay, in multi-programming environment there will be many processes as well as many resources. Process needs resource to complete the task. Okay, so if a task is given to the process, it will request for the resource in order to successfully complete the task. Okay, so what happens is there will be many number of processes as well as there will be many resources. Okay, but the thing is, for example, let us consider there are three processes. Okay, so and let us consider some resources as well. Now let's see this example in order to understand what is deadlock. So there are three processes. Okay, process one has resource one. Okay, and process two has resource two. Process three is requesting for resource 2 and process 2 is requesting for resource 1 and process 1 is requesting for resource 3. See, I am explaining better now. I'll explain you clearly. See, process 1 is having resource 1 with it, process 2 is having resource 2 with it, process 3 is having resource 3 with it. But the thing is, process 3 is requesting for process 1 is requesting for resource 3, but resource 3 cannot be allocated to process 1 because it is resource 3 is already with process 3. Okay, so as the request of the process 1 is not successful, process 1 went to waiting state. Okay, see, when a process asks for resources, if the resource is not available, then the process will automatically go to the waiting state. Okay, so process 1 asked process 3 for resource 3, but process 3 is already using resource 3, so process 1 went off to waiting stage. So process 1 now is not available because it is in waiting stage. Now, as process 1 is in waiting stage. See, process 2 is having resource 2, but it is asking process 1 to allocate resource 1. It is already use like process 1 is already using resource 1. Process 1 is already using resource 1. But the thing is, the same resource is being asked by process 2. So it is not going to get resource 1 because it is already being used by process 1, so it also went to waiting stage. Now process 3 is requesting for resource 2, but the thing is, process 2 is already using resource 2, so it is not getting its requested resource, so it also went to waiting stage. So all the three processes went to waiting stage. It is a deadlock situation because 3 went to waiting stage and now P1 cannot get R3 resource 3, P2 cannot get resource 1, like that, because all are in waiting stage and it is like a deadlock situation. Until one releases the resource, other two cannot come out of the waiting stage. So this is called the waiting stage, which is the reason for the deadlock to happen. But in our environment, deadlock is not good to occur because deadlock is nothing but, see, all the three resources are not used now properly because all are in All are book locked with the processes. See, process one, resource one has been locked by process one, and process one is not using resource one because it went to waiting stage. So all three are in waiting stage. So resources are not used properly. So this particular situation is not should not be occurred. So deadlock is, I have explained to you what is deadlock. Now let's see what is deadlock prevention. How to prevent the deadlock situation? Okay. Because deadlock is not good to occur. So now let's see what is deadlock prevention, that is how to avoid, that is how to prevent the deadlock situation. First case is like how to avoid prevent the deadlock is mutual exclusion. Mutual exclusion means there are some three processes. There are, for example, three resources. We have to put at least few resources as unshareable. Means this particular resource should not be shared. This should be exclusive to only particular process. Then, see, for example, if this is exclusive and this is unshareable, like process 1 and process 2 cannot share resource 3. Only process 3 can share the resource 3. It means process 1 and process 2 can request only within these two. At least one of the process will be out of the deadlock situation so that it can help other two processes to get out of the deadlock situation. Got this? So the next, the second different solution where you can prevent the deadlock is hold and wait. Okay, for example, there are two resources and two processes. Process one is holding resource one, it is already holding resource one, then it cannot request resource two. Okay, got it? When it is already having a resource with it, it cannot request for another resource. Okay. Same with P2 also. If process one, process two is holding resource two, then process two simultaneously cannot request for resource two, resource one. Okay. So hence we can overcome the problem of deadlock prevention. Okay. And the third different procedure which we can use in order to solve the particular process is no preemption. No preemption is, for example, there are two processes and there are two resources. Process one is holding resource one, okay, and process one is holding resource one as well as it is requesting for resource two. In that case, if a process is already holding a resource and it is requesting for some other resource, then immediately it should release this resource one. Okay, the resource which is already locked with the process should be released. Then only it can request some other resource. Okay, if P1 wants to access resource 2, then it should release the resource which is already it is having, and then only it can go with another resource requesting. Okay, and the last but not least, deadlock avoidance means how to avoid the deadlock. It is nothing but first important thing is we have to understand what is the safe state and what is unsafe state. Okay, there are two different states. First, you need to understand this, then only you can understand what is deadlock avoidance. Okay, so this is an environment, multitasking environment. Okay, so this is a complete environment, and this environment is divided into two parts. This is part one and this is part two. Here there is a deadlock. Okay, in this part one there is a deadlock. So The part one is having deadlock, so it is called unsafe state. Okay, in part two, there are no deadlocks, so it is called as safe state. Got it? The place, like the environment which does not contains deadlock is safe state. The environment which contains the deadlock is unsafe state. Okay, now let's see how we can avoid this particular deadlock. It can be avoided using Bankers algorithm. Bankers algorithm. Why this name Bankers algorithm is used is because this particular process is used in banking system. Okay, so in Bankers algorithm, first the process the new process whenever it enters into the system, then it should first only declare that how many resources it requires. Okay, so I'm explaining again. When a new process enters into the system, it should first only tell how many resources it needs. Okay, and the thing is, the process cannot request more than the resources which are available. Okay, it means the process cannot request more than maximum number of available resources. Okay, see, for example, a process is requesting for, okay, for example, there are 100 resources and the process is requesting for 101 resource. This is wrong. This should not happen. Okay, if there are 100 resources, the process should request less than 100 resources. Okay, so this is called the Bankers algorithm. And some other cases are available. Like, these are the terms which are used in the Bankers algorithm. First one is available. The available number of resources in the system is available. Available means how many resources, how many number of resources are available in the environment. Okay, that is meant by available. Next is max. Max means the maximum number of resources that the process requests for. Okay, that the process requests. Okay, that is called max. And allocation. Allocation means currently how many resources are allocated to process. That is called allocation. Last but not least, need. Need means how many resources are needed by the process. Okay, this is called need. This is the Bankers algorithm. This particular topic coming to operating system is very important, that is deadlocks detection, deadlocks avoidance, prevention and all. Hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, as well as don't forget to hit the bell icon for more such wonderful videos. Thanks for watching my video, and please like and share this video with all your friends, and all the very best for your exams.